and gentlemen and ladies, good evening. You are welcome in today's zoology class organized by Society of Carrier Technology and Gen Vikas Mahasabha. Today we will talk about ribosome. Ribosome is a platform for synthesis of protein. And before coming on the topic, I would like to ask you a puzzle. Is it possible that 50 plus 30 make 70, 40 plus 30 make 55, 60 plus 40 make 80. In the first instance, it appears that it is ridiculous, but it is a fact in case of ribosome, because in case of ribosome, its dimension is not expressed in its length, width. It is expressed in the sedimentation coefficient at which speed it is separated during centrifugation of the cell substance. And it is the Swedberg unit or S. So, ribosome is interesting in the sense that always it has two components, a smaller subunit and a smaller subunit. And their size is expressed by the speed of sedimentation coefficient at which they get separated. So here what happens, the two subunits of prokaryotes, they are 50 plus 30 S and it makes 70 S. So it is not additive. In case of mitochondrial ribosome, the bigger subunit is 40S, smaller subunit is 30S, and the total becomes 55S. In case of eukaryote mitochondria, it is larger subunit 60S, smaller subunit 40S, and the total becomes 80S. So in the cell, both subunits normally remain separate. Either they are present free in the cytoplasmic matrix as free ribosome, or they may remain attached with the wall of rough endoplasmic reticulum or RER. You know, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, one SER and another RER. In RER we have attached ribosome. So, the ribosomes were discovered in 1955 by Pallett. And they are platform for protein synthesis. What is protein synthesis? Actually, father of genetics, Mendel, had said that in every organism, for controlling every body character, there is one something something. What is that something something? He did not know. He did not explain. But he said that in every organism, whether a plant or an animal, there are one pair of something something which he called factors. So for controlling every body character, for example, our eye color, whether it is black, brown or blue, or other hereditary characters, we have one pair of factors, at least one pair. Sometimes there may be more than one pair. So at least one pair of factors are there for controlling every body character, out of which one is obtained from the maternal parent and one is obtained from the paternal parent. Again, in this next generation, in the progeny, during gamete formation, the two factors separate from each other. What are these factors? Later on it was came to be known that these factors are actually the genes, and which are made up of DNA molecule. And DNA molecule is made up of four types of nitrogenous bases: adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, plus phosphoric acid and a 2-deoxyribose sugar. And different characters are due to different types of proteins. Proteins are polymers of amino acids there are 20 types of amino acids, but and they get arranged like different words in a different alphabets in a word and in a sentence. At which place which amino acid has to be added is very important, and it is controlled by the nucleotide sequence of the genes. But the genes are present inside nucleus, and whereas the proteins are synthesized in the cytoplasm on the ribosomal platform. The detail we will talk about different types of RNA and different steps of protein synthesis later on. Here we are concerned only to emphasize the importance of this cytoplasmic organelle ribosome, which acts as a platform for protein synthesis. As it can be compared with a homologous situation. In our society, what happens? Suppose we, one dozen friends, wish to go to Delhi to see, observe the 26 January program. What happens? One is residing in another locality, the next one is residing in another locality. Everyone gets their seat registered in the train going to New Delhi. After that, when that day arrives, when they have to go, everyone comes out from his residence, hire a taxi or auto, reaches on railway station, come down from the tempo, reach on the platform, and at that platform what happens? One railway employee comes, brings the copy of registration chart, pastes on the railway coach, and TTE comes there. He translates the message, one message which has been printed on that reservation chart, and he translates it into the message of living beings of different names and advise them to sit on that particular seat. Similar situation here also. So like the platform here, the ribosome acts as a platform, and here it has to accommodate on that platform the railway train, the TTE, the passenger, and it has to make a coordination between them. How it occurs? It occurs in the ribosome, and it has been observed that the two subunits of ribosome remain separate normally in the cytoplasm. Its alignment depends upon magnesium ion concentration. When the magnesium ion concentration increases, the two subunits of ribosome come together, join, and then the messenger RNA, transfer RNA carrying the amino acid bind with its tunnel. So, for this purpose, the ribosomes have been made. And there is a smaller subunit, there is a larger subunit, and it provides a platform for the translation of the message between the traveling ticket examiner and the passenger. So what happens? In 1974, two of the scientists, one was Stoffler and other was Leek, they studied the structure of ribosome on the basis of their X-ray diffraction pattern. And they said that this smaller subunit of the prokaryote and the larger subunit, and in between them there is a tunnel, and that is the most important point. So what happens? From nucleus, a messenger RNA molecule comes and just attach here. It has many codon. Codon is a group of three nitrogenous bases which identify one amino acid, and just adjacent to them a postman molecule, the tRNA. They have one end containing the anticodon, which is complementary base sequence of the codon sequence of the mRNA, and on the tail we have amino acid. So there are two sites in ribosome, A site and B site. And first, tRNA containing the amino acid comes to attach at the A site. Then there is a movement like translocation. Suppose this is the position, it moves this way. This is A site and this is P site. So first of all, the first tRNA binds at A site, then it moves to the P site. A site again becomes vacant for another tRNA, and the amino acids bind with each other to form a polypeptide chain. This way the process goes on. So this was the purpose which have to be performed by the ribosome. Let us see what is their structure and how that structure helps in that particular function. So, as I said to you that there are three types of ribosomes. One, which are found in mitochondria and chloroplast. Second, which are found in the prokaryote cell. And third, which are found in the eukaryote cell. About the prokaryote, ribosome found in the prokaryote cell, they are 70S, and the two subunits are 30S and 50S. The 30S subunit contains one ribosomal RNA of 16S, made up of molecular weight 550,000 and 1600 nucleotides, along with 21 proteins. On the other hand, the 50S subunit contains 34 proteins and two types of ribosomal RNA, one larger 23S ribosomal RNA, molecular weight 3200 and it's 3200 nucleotides and molecular weight is 1100,000. The 5S ribosomal RNA contains 120 nucleotides and its molecular weight is about 40,000. So at the time of function, both ribosomal subunits bind with each other. A tunnel is formed in which the mRNA and tRNA are brought. So there are two position of ribosome. They may be present as in the free form in the cytoplasmic matrix, or they may be attached with RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. The chloroplast or mitochondrial ribosome is made up of 30S and 40S subunits, and complete structure form 55S. In case of prokaryote ribosome, it is complete ribosome is 70S and the two components are 30S and 50S. The eukaryote ribosome have two subunits, one 40S, second 60S, and the total becomes 80S. Number of ribosome per cell may be, in prokaryote cell, one cell may contain 10,000 ribosomes, and in eukaryote cell, it may be 1 into 10 to the power 6 to 1 into 10 to the power 7. And in each ribosome, we get that there are two seats for the attachment of molecules. One is A site, and other is P site. Average diameter is ribosome is about 150 to 200 angstrom. So another very interesting thing was that in 1974, Courland gave a detailed description about actual crystal structure of mitochondria. And there are two views. One was given by Stoffler and Wittmann's model, and second was Lake's model. And in this Stoffler and Wittmann model, they say that the 50S subunit is having one kidney-shaped body and there is a dent. And the smaller subunit, 30S subunit, it is like very much like old receiver of telephone set which was used in our houses. It contains one third part a head and two third part a body. So as there is a constriction here, it makes a tunnel when the two subunits combine, and in this tunnel the mRNA, tRNA molecules come together and attach with each other. Lake's model is also similar, but it shows that the 30S subunit has a smaller subunit, upper one-third part, lower two-third part, there is a cleft in between, and the 50S subunit also contains a central protuberance along with two lateral wings, and when the two combines with each other they make such shape. So this is also one very important discovery in biological sciences during last 70-80 years, which has totally changed the science thinking and scientific study and contributed a lot in our understanding. This much for the day. Thank you very much.